A few routes to reach there. There are three routes actually. One is the Nalichi Wat, which I have not attempted because it is fully rock climbing. This is the Tolarkhind route, which is partly rock climbing. And so this leads to a place called Kokan Kada. Now Kokan Kada is basically a cliff, which is like say 3.5 kilometers steep. It is just a free fall, and it is in fact a little bit concave, so that the wind currents are so strong that it is advised that you don't bend because you get flown away. So literally, no, not me, I'm too heavy. So literally they have dug holes near the cliff so that you get into the hole, you lie down on your tummy, and then you look down. The currents are so strong that if you throw a piece of paper, it will come up. But it's a beautiful view, and the sunset from Kokan Kada is something that you need to experience. Now, I have done some photography, but photos really can't replace the real thing. In fact, one of my friends has been to the Grand Canyon, and he came for Kokan Kada, Harishchandragarh. He actually said it, that this seems to be more captivating than the Grand Canyon. We don't know why we are not promoting it as a tourist destination. But in fact, my response to that was, it is good that we are not promoting it as a tourist destination, because as a country or as a people, we don't have the civic sense. The more tourists would have come here, we would have spoiled the pristine beauty of the place. And that is really a God's gift that we have not been promoting such beautiful spots. Today, this place is accessible only by hikes. You have to hike for at least 5-6 hours to reach this place. But really, that is one reason why the unspoiled nature is still intact. See, this is Kokan Kada. Okay, now these are some photographs which I have taken, which I love, because this is one temple at Silvassa. I love the architecture. It's a Swaminarayan temple. This is somewhere in the Sahyadri. So, okay, now for last 1 year, I have been having high parathyroid hormone levels, and due to which I got terrible bone pain. I underwent a surgery for parathyroidectomy, but my bone pain has not reduced. So anyway, that's a different thing. But I'm not able to hike, so I go on road trips. What I do is I take my car, I simply get going on some route that I know is very picturesque. At any point I like, I just stop the car, I do my photography, take the car, go to the next point. So it's just that I feel alive when I'm in the midst of nature. This is a place called Tamini Ghat, which is also very beautiful. This is Mumbai actually. This is a place called Sivri Jetty. How many of you would have heard about it?
Sivri Jetty.
So there is a jetty at Sivri which is mostly defunct. Nobody uses it. There are a lot of these ships which are just lying there idle. Okay, this is a place called Vedas. Vedas is in Ratnagiri district. It has a very beautiful beach. Vedas is known
is
more for
extension of the Mazagon docks,
is it? Sivri, yes. Yeah. Sivri is an extension of the Mazagon docks.
Yes. Then that's possible.
It's in the harbour line, yeah. Correct. This is a place called Vedas. Now Vedas is known more for conservation of olive ridley turtles. Oh. I do a lot of service for conservation of olive ridley turtles. So Vedas is the place where the conservation movement started. And today we have created documentation and SOPs, etc. And we are teaching it to more villages along the coastline so that the same activity is sort of replicated along more beaches. Now this is a Vedas beach where this is actually not a single photograph, but it's a combination of three photographs which I have clicked in one shot. So it's called bracketing. It's a technique that is used. And then I merged these photographs to give it a look of a painting. So if you see this photograph, it looks more like a painting, but it is actually three photographs merged into one. So these techniques I learned over a period of time. This is a beautiful temple at Ambarnath. Ambarnath is the middle of center of the town, but this temple is ancient, and it still looks very beautiful. The sculpture, etc., is intact. So this is again Sivri. This is where the flamingos come every year. I think now the flamingos would be there. Anybody wants to see flamingos can go to Sivri. There's the right time to go there, so it's something to the tide. So typically the best time to go would be say 1.5 after low tide. 1.5 hour after low tide. But this photograph is one of my favorites because you have one egret in the middle of all these flamingos. And it looks very nice to me. I also do photography within the city. So I observed that this is VT or CST, and the sun rises from behind CST. But I don't know how many people have really observed that. So I went early morning and I thought I'll get a silhouette of CST. Now, one of my strengths in photography is that I have a very stable hand, they say. So even in low light, I'm able to get very good exposures without use of any flash, etc. So all these photographs have been clicked by a camera in manual mode, okay, handheld, without any tripod and without any flash. And I'm proud of these photographs. This is actually my Kuldevi temple, Shantadurga temple at Goa. That's our family deity. So this is the temple. This is again clicked in very low light, without any flash or
it's handheld.
Most importantly, handheld, because in low light, handheld photography, this exposure would be for like say half a second or something. And for half a second, if your hand, normally it shakes even a little bit, and then the whole photograph blurs. But I think I have this ability to have a very steady hand. This is the festival that there was. So they take the idol of the goddess and take it to the lake, etc. Okay, this is again Sivri, which is low light photography. I like this photograph because it has captured the details of that ship, especially at the top side. The details have been captured very nicely. This is again that Silvassa temple, which I showed earlier. Now this was towards evening and there was very low light, and this is again handheld photography. Okay, this is, I had used a tripod here. Lot of times I do crazy things, so like this is one of the crazy things that I have done. This photograph has been clicked at Marine Drive in Mumbai at 1:30 a.m. So I just took my car, I was getting bored, I was not able to sleep that night. I don't know for what reason. And then I just took my car, I took my camera with a tripod. I went out to Marine Drive, and this is a tripod shot, this is not a handheld shot. But this is a 30 seconds exposure. So that is why you see the light, you know, spreading out. And I think this sort of captures the essence of what Marine Drive is all about. This is again similar, but this is again a low light. Okay, this is some fun that we had. So whenever I do camping, these kind of photography I do. So this, what we do is, there's something called a bulb mode in photography. You keep it on bulb mode and you take a laser lamp, or this is a torch, I think. and we ask somebody to stand there and we trace the outline of the person, and this is how it looks.